Here is my share about what happened last week with this guy. And I'd like to introduce him to you and tell you a little bit about our history together, because it makes what happened even more significant. And this is a big validation right here. I know some people in the group don't work with horses quite the same way that some of us do. And whenever they do things that we call releasing stress or tension, like that yawn was one of them, that blowing out of his nose, licking and chewing, resting a hind foot. Whenever horses do that, due to their prey nature, they have been able to relax. And what helps them be able to relax are when things are congruent, when they look as they seem. So there's the validation right there too. So in the wild, if there's wild grass growing over there and it looks as it should, it's not moving funny, he can put his head down and eat or exhibit some of those signs of relaxation. If that grass starts to move in a funny way, there could be a cougar in there, which means the horse is going to want to run away because they could turn into lunch. So they also react to how we are in our own frequency, or if we are in alignment, and when our body, mind, and spirit are all coming together into our authentic truth, oftentimes the horses will exhibit those signs of relaxation. So just the fact that when I started talking and he yawned, that helps me want to continue sharing the story. Officially, if I ever registered this horse, his name would be Sunshine to my heart. And I got him when he was 2.5 years old, and at that time I had gotten back into the world of dressage and wanted to find a horse that could do all the fancy stuff. Because I had spent a lot of years learning about dressage and the biomechanics and helping horses that I used to call basically reconstituted reps. They were either lame or had some type of physical discomfort, or they were very, very silly mentally, which now I know there's not a lot of difference in between the two. But at the time, I just thought I either worked with silly horses or the physical reps and got them moving better and doing better. And then I would pass them along because I was a working student and my trainer got to ride them. So I was looking to buy a horse that had the movement and the potential to do all that big and fancy stuff. And so, after I got him, one thing happened that was pretty significant. I became a mom, and that altered our training schedule quite a bit. And the other thing that happened was he started to say no. And he developed, I think he kind of came with it actually, but he had a habit of, if he didn't particularly care for what was going on, he would tip his nose away from wherever you were standing with the lead rope and run and jerk the rope out of your hand. And I recognized that that was something, that obviously that was a problem, and so I went in search of ways to how to figure that out. And along the way, I really cracked open and started working with horses in a completely different way. And now it's the kind of the foundation for the healing work that the horses facilitate with me, as well as working with riders to develop confidence in themselves and their horses. And as I progressed on the journey, I realized, first of all, how much of an outlier I always tend to be, but at the same time, how really listening to my horse and paying attention to what's happening can make a big difference. One of the challenges that I found in working with this horse, and he had this, this condition, I guess, since I got him too. And I don't know if you can see his tail in the video, but whenever I would approach him about here or that, well, he's doing a little bit He would swish his tail. And I had never worked with a horse that consistently did that, and it used to be much worse. He would swish and swish and swish, and it wouldn't stop. And so I had answers from people ranging all the way from, oh, I think maybe it was something positive, and he did that when he was nursing as a foal. And I had a lot more people tell me that basically it was a bad habit and it needed to be corrected. He needed to learn manners, he needed to learn respect. In fact, that was pretty much what we heard from, well, just about everybody that we didn't listen to or fight with, because I knew that there was something about him. There was a reason why he was exhibiting these behaviors. It wasn't that just he was choosing to be a bad horse. And so I started doing some release work with him, and we were trained in the Masterson method, and they use the horse's bladder meridian, which runs all the way down their top line on either side and down here, and they use that because all of the other meridians empty into it, and you can help the horse release tension by applying a light pressure to that nervous system. And from doing this, I started to notice that even before the horse licked and chewed, things happened. The blink of their eyes might change. Sometimes they'll get a little twitch under their eye in that muscle. Sometimes their muzzle, it will twitch, or the muscles will kind of ripple. Sometimes their breathing will change. Sometimes their ears will move just the tiniest bit. And so I started to notice that oftentimes our horses have a whole lot going on. And in the horse world, there can be a lot of pressure to get things done, to make it to a show, to complete. Sometimes it's just to complete a trainer's agenda. But at the same time, now right there, his chin is quivering a little bit. It doesn't give our horses the time and space to get what they need. And of course, some horses have a much harder life than others, but just our human nature sometimes, and the things that we ask of horses, or even living in the herds, they end up adopting tensions, or not adopting, but living with them. And so the more that we can help them release these tensions, it's really holding space. The more that we can hold the space for the horse, the more that they can step into it and release whatever tensions that they've taken on and be able to be freer in their mind and freer in their body. And I find, too, that the more that I call this listening to the horse and looking for those signs of tension, the more that they offer, and that can result in great magic during the session. So I was doing a little bit of the releasing work with Sunshine here, and we've been doing it about a year and a half, and I just finally got that I wasn't going to try anymore to reach any goal with him other than getting him happy and comfortable. And then whatever we did on top of that or with that would just be a bonus, because I didn't feel like he deserved to feel that tight about anything. So he also, now he's being a very, very good model right here, but there was a time where I had to be very, very careful about haltering him. And of course there were days where he chose not to be haltered. He would run off. He would also bite. And fortunately, he never has put his teeth on my skin, but I've also blocked him because I've been aware that that's his habit and tendency, and I don't want to lose skin or get blood. And so he also wasn't always very responsive to your space, and he would just kind of try to walk into you or over you. So basically, I think I might have said a little bit before, he would have been labeled bad manners, and you know, your job is to drill good manners into him. And again, that just wasn't how we were going to do things. So the other day, when I was working with him, I have this cool little comb that, it's actually a dog grooming comb. One of my clients turned me on to this, and I think it helps stimulate points on them like acupressure would. And so I know it's small, but this would be part of our routine, in that I just go over pretty much every inch of them. I love women, so this is not a treacherous thing for me by any means. And this horse used to not stand still for grooming either. He would dance around, he would move around. It just wasn't pleasant for him. And so now we even are getting to the point where there's hardly any tail swishing. And you can see he's getting a little bit more of that sleepy look in his eye. And so when I was combing him here, all of a sudden I had an overwhelming feeling of, it was a little bit of sadness, but it was resonance and it was very strong, and I started to cry. And one of the beautiful things about interacting with horses in this way is we're all connected. And it doesn't matter where that feeling came from, originated, or why it was there. The fact was that it was coming up and it needed to be released. And there seemed to be kind of a message in that about trust. And so I just hung out here for a little bit and let that emotion pass. And this horse too, with his very, very strong personality, being a leader for him has pushed my self-growth to new levels for sure. Because I have to have enough of the gentle strength to be able to make a request at times and stick with it, but understand he has to do it in his time. And for probably of the year and a half that we've been doing this, all but the last 2 months, all I did was release. And then it became apparent that I needed to help him a little more with his security. So I took on a little bit stronger role as the leader and made some more requests rather than just letting him run the show. And that has really, I think, shifted our relationship too, because I think he is taking that security. And it feels so good to be able to offer it. So after that emotional release, I came over to this side. And it was very hot, and I was still kind of processing things. And so I bent down like this. And while I was down in this position, Sunshine, or Little Horse as I call him often, he moved himself around. And I'm going to make sure, because again, knowing that this horse did not have, as the horse will say, good manners, you know, that when he feels uncomfortable, he would bite or crash into you. I did the best that I could to just breathe and not guard, because he put himself like this. And I think that this is probably the underbelly. It has to be the most vulnerable place on him. And for him to deliberately push me there into that vulnerability, I found it to be pretty amazing.
Sunshine.
And I think it really just spoke of self-trust to me. And with all of the ways that I'm adjusting my internal landscape to be able to work on my message and share my gifts outward, this just seemed like it was too huge not to share. And again, because I just wanted to give you a little bit of history of this horse, of why it was so incredible. So that's my story. This is my Sunshine to My Heart. And who knows where we're going to end up, but you know what? We are loving every moment of this So thanks for saying hi to my horse, and I will see you guys later.